It's time for Mastering Your Money with Gary Mastrodonato.
My good friend Zig Ziglar once told me, Gary, people don't really care how much you know until they know how much you care about them.
Every week, Gary brings you up to date in the world of finance and gives you tried and true retirement tips from his office at the Masters Wealth Management Group in Oriental, North Carolina.
It's the decisions you make in life when you have a choice that will determine where you'll be in life when you no longer have a choice.
For 40 years, Gary has passionately served his clients, helping them retire with confidence.
You know, we treat all of our clients the absolute same. There are no minimums here at the Masters Wealth Management Group.
Now, let's put the wind in your financial sails and your success. Here he is, the master, Gary Mastrodonato.
Well, hi, everybody. Gary Mastrodonato, the mid-February edition of the Mastering Your Money program. And almost halfway through February, hard to believe already, this year is just skating by. And so much going on in the economy, so much going on in your retirement plan, so much going on in your income and your inflationary spending and your food shopping and trying to keep your family and economics alive is a certain full-time job today. We're going to be discussing that on the Mastering the Money program. Our specialty, of course, retirement distribution. We've been doing it for 41 years. What does all that mean? Well, part of that means, how do we dismiss the money that we accumulated through our lifetime for retirement? We got Social Security. We have a 401k plan. We got a pension plan. We have savings that we save for our lifetime through retirement or for retirement. What money should we spend? I mean, I'm used to just going to the bank and pulling money out and making that deposit into my checking account. But it's different in retirement because minus all those items, there's no paycheck. And the paycheck that we have to provide for ourselves comes from the savings, the Social Security, the 401ks, the IRAs, the pension if you have one at work, whatever the case is, a variety of income tools. Which one do you spend first? Crucial in how long your retirement will last. That's what we specialize in. We also specialize in putting the cream of the crop on the very top of the cupcake, and that's the whipped cream with the sprinkles. We call that the long-term care plan. And I'm telling you, there's a lot to be talking about that as well. And of course, Dr. Larry Kotlikoff, our Social Security specialist, joins us live on the second half of today's show. You don't want to miss a minute of that interview. He's the nation's guru on Social Security. But before, as always, we take a pause to honor our heroes, our nation's heroes, our military men and women that keep us safe 24/7 year-round. We never forget our veterans because they paved the way and got the road ready for where we are today. And of course, we thank our police and other people that keep us safe, and the healthcare workers and first responders, and anybody that has anything to do with helping someone else. We thank you as well. Let's take a pause to honor all of our heroes.
And I'm proud to be an American.
We're back. Lee Greenwood, God Bless USA, always a favorite, and brings a tear to my eye, and of course, hopefully to yours as well, as we thank Americans and the military that keep us safe year-round. And, you know, our police are working hard as well, and they got a lot of bad rap lately, but there's good and bad in every group, and all the police people I've met are very good people, and we honor them and respect them and respect the badge that they put on. When they put a badge on, they have no idea what their day is going to be like or if that day will end with them alive. So they're brave out there, and we thank you for what you do. Anyway, a pleasure to be with you on the Mastering Your Money program, mid-February 2023. A lot going on. The president spoke with the State of the Union address. Nevertheless, call it what you like, but we want action. We need money. We want inflation stopped. We want lowering prices at the food market. They're still rising. We want lower prices at the gas pump, and they're rising again. We want prices of other items to drop down, and they're rising, and a lot of interest rates are rising. Inflation's rising. The chances of recession full blown is rising, and here we sit. But we have a solution, and the solution is we're here to help you along the road from retirement all the way to life end. That's our solution, the Masters Wealth Management Group, in business for 41 years. And of course, as always, we are there for you 24/7 on the 252-249-0100 Masters hotline. You call us anytime you want, morning, noon, or night. Someone will always answer the phone and at least get a message over to us to get back to you ASAP. Today's program, we're going to be talking about what money do we spend first. And, you know, these topics are not easy. I can't raise the bar on these topics without my co-host and my esteemed co-host. And only one special person in America can do this job the way that I want it done. And that's Mr. Jeff Shea. Jeffrey, welcome to the program, as always, sir.
Thank you so much, Gary. And as always, you are too kind, my friend. It is a real pleasure to be with you here on Mastering Your Money, and especially all the fine people here in Eastern North Carolina and all of our new friends in Port St. Lucie, Florida. We've got some great shows, by the way, on our podcast. Go to wherever you get your podcast. Search Gary Master Donato, Mastering Your Money, and you'll find a lot of shows there. I'm sure there's one that will apply to you. Gary, you said something interesting in the beginning of the program, and it got me to thinking, you know, you spend a lot of years accumulating money in your retirement plans. Now it's time for the distribution phase of your retirement. The question that I have for you, Gary, is how do we know of all the different investments we have, how do we know which is the right one to pull from first?
Well, that's a great question, and that's something that we've studied for a long time and really put into practice over many years of experience, because that really helps out a lot. You know, you can't replace experience in this business. You cannot replace experience in the business of open heart surgery from the surgeon. You can't replace experience with the money management and the retirement distribution team of the people that are guiding you through retirement. There's not everybody that can do it this way. It's a special training. Very few people are trained to that effect, so don't be caught short or misled on all the other fancy names that you might hear people say. Oh, we are fiduciaries, so you got to do business with us. I'm tired of that word fiduciary, and it doesn't really mean anything other than the fact that we all want to do what's in our client's best interest at all times, and we've always done that here at the Masters Wealth Management Group. But it has nothing to do with how you charge your client. I mean, there's people on the radio that say they're fiduciaries, and they charge commissions, and they charge fees, and they charge any which way but loose that they want to collect fees from you in any way that they can. Yet they're the first to say, we are the fiduciaries of the radio waves. And that's not true at all. We're all fiduciaries. If we're in practice and helping people retire, we are fiduciaries. And we are fiduciaries here at the Masters Wealth Management Group as well. And we always do what's in your best interest, and have always done what's in your best interest for 41 years. Are we always right? No, we're not always right. No one's always right, but in 41 years, we really try our very best. And this business is ingrained in my heart and in my soul. And I work day and night for our clients, for our clients' betterment, especially in the last few years of the markets being so erratic all over the boards. You want somebody with 41 years of experience. And the team of people we put together are so impressive. Our coaching staff is like a who's who in the economic world. I mean, you got Ed Slott, you got Dr. Larry Kotlikoff, who you'll hear from in just a few minutes live on the program on Social Security, our doctor of economics from Harvard, talking about Social Security and why it's so important to maximize it out properly. And not only that, Dr. K gave me a design software piece that we use in the practice every day. So when you call us and do business with us, you get to have Dr. Kotlikoff's Social Security software that he designed for the master and anyone else who wants to have it, of course. But we use the pro version that he designed, and not only designed it, he taught me how to use it. And there's a big difference in that respect. But that's the case. But, you know, we sit down. So, you know, we've retired. We worked 40 years. We got 10,000 hours under our belt. What do we do now? We look at our accounts and say, well, honey, we're going to take that retirement. We just signed the retirement papers today at ABC Company, and I'm delighted to hear it. Here's my pension numbers. Here's my Social Security projection numbers. Here's my 401k amount value. And here's how much we got in the bank account. Where do we go from here? Well, we got to set up a budget, number one. We got to find out what your budget is. We got to find out in total what your monthly obligations are. No different if you're going for a job somewhere when you're first starting off at work. You got to add up your car payments, your house payments, your medical bills, your health insurance, your homeowner's insurance, and all the different things you got to have along the way to make sure that you're in a good position to pay those bills. If your money's in the stock market, you know, an average listener last year. In year 2022, their 401k accounts have dropped on average of 24.6%. 24.6%. It's a big drop down, and it's not back. I mean, the market's come back a little bit this year, up and down, very, very volatile. When the market can fall 700-800 points in a day, and you're retired, it's a bad time to be in the market. If you need to wake up a little bit further on that one, come see me. What's wrong with keeping your money very, very safe right now, keeping it out of harm's way, and getting a fair return on your money without any risk at all, where you sleep at night every night? And one of the things we use in our portfolio management is a special kind of an account we're going to talk about in a moment, and it has part to do with how and what money we spend first. We want to maximize Social Security, as you'll hear in a few minutes from Dr. Kotlikoff. So, you know, we turn on Social Security at 62 versus age 70. That's 8 years away. It's a 76% difference in income between 62 and 70. Now, we want to grow that depending on health. Do we want to grow that depending on wealth, depending on your goals and objectives? Are you still working? Are you still not working? There's a lot of moving parts in that formulation. It's an important formulation. The 401ks we can keep safe, no question about it. We can roll them to an IRA, and we can use the master plan to keep those safe. The master plan is going to pay you 20% bonus if you're age 73 or less. The master plan is going to give you a 4.05% guarantee year one. The master plan removes all risk of any market principal. You won't lose a penny in the market. You won't lose a penny anywhere in that master plan. You'll have a 24.05% betterment from the day you give us the money going out 1 year if you're 73 years old or younger. If you're above 73, it's a change, but there's also other factors that go into that. But that's part of the master plan. We maximize out your Social Security. We maximize out your pension monies and your options when you retire if you have a pension. And we maximize out your savings to keep them safe. We reduce your taxation, and we add a plan for long-term care at the end of that street, because long-term care may be the end of your street in life. We don't want to drain your accounts, and we don't want you to run out of money if you live for a long time and you have to have additional help in the home or outside the home. So those are the things about what money to spend first. You won't know what money to spend first. We know from experience how it should be done. We're not going to charge you anything to do it, but you do have to pick up the phone, and you have to call us at 252-249-0100, 252-249-0100. First 10 callers today that call us get the master plan review, no charge, 20 minutes on the telephone with the master, no charge, and a copy of Dr. Larry Kotlikoff's Money Magic in my left hand right now, his latest book on economic secrets to more money, less risk, and a better life. Basically, it's the master plan. So give us a call at 252-249-0100.
Our show's called Mastering Your Money with Gary Mastro Donato, and it's time for a break. When we come back, we'll be talking with Dr. Larry Kotlikoff, Harvard-educated professor at Boston University, and Dr. Kotlikoff will talk about Social Security. All that and more when our show continues after this.
You've probably heard people giving advice about sticking it out. And while that may come in handy when it comes to things like losing weight, it can be outright reckless advice when it comes to investing and planning for your retirement. Gary Mastro Donato of Masters Wealth Management meets with people every day who've been given this blanket advice from the big Wall Street firms, because as long as your money's in the market, they're making money. This is why it's so important to know if you're working with an advisor who's putting your best interest ahead of their own. The problem with the sticking it out mentality is that it doesn't take into consideration the intersection of market risk and your personal time horizon. Get a customized financial plan based on your personal needs and goals. To get your personal retirement master plan, call 252-249-0100. Schedule your no-obligation complimentary review today. Gary will personally meet with you to discuss your goals and help you create your financial strategy that aligns with your retirement plan. That number again, 252-249-0100. Or request your plan online at masterswealth.com. Money, 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 money.
We're back. Gary Master Donato, the Master in Your Money program, mid-February 2023. We've asked Dr. Larry Kotlikoff to come on board and join us today. Doctor's our Social Security coach and has written a few books on Social Security. Get What's Yours and his latest book, Money Magic, is here in my left hand. Dr. Kotlikoff, welcome to the Master in Your Money show, sir.
Great to be back with you, Gary.
our first leg of the stool when we retire somebody, Dr. Kotlikoff, is we always start with making sure that they've taken full advantage of maximizing their Social Security. That's the base number. 92% of Americans all have Social Security. They paid into the system. They got the benefit. Most of them don't use it right, and 92% of Americans own it. So what are some of the things that somebody needs to key in on when they're thinking about retirement from ages 62 to 70 are the key pivot ages that you can make choices on? So let's start there.
Well, the big thing that everyone needs to know is there's enormous return to patients. If you wait till 70 to collect your retirement benefit, it's going to be 76% higher adjusted for inflation than if you start taking it at 62. There's also 13 benefits in total from Social Security. And with Social Security, it's use it or lose it. So you need to understand all the benefits and what's available to you. If you got divorced after you were married for 10 years, you can collect divorce spousal benefits. You can collect divorce widow benefits. If you're a stay-at-home dad watching a disabled child and your wife might be collecting retirement benefit, maybe you had adopted a child, for example, is disabled. Well, you can collect not only disabled child benefits for the child based on your wife's retirement benefit collection, but also you can collect what's called a child and care spousal benefit for the husband, for the stay-at-home dad. So there's lots of benefits. There's even a parent benefit. If you've been taking care of your older parent and providing more than half of their support and you die, they can collect up to 75% of your benefit. Now, there's also things like family benefit maximum that limit how much dependents can receive on your record. So there's lots of interconnected parts here. I have through my company, a software program for $39. It's called MaximizeMySocialSecurity.com. MaximizeMySocialSecurity.com. You can get it right with $39 in a few minutes. If you go to Social Security, they will often do things because the staffers are not well trained. They tell you things that are incomplete or inaccurate. There's all kinds of people that are being screwed over by Social Security itself. You have widows who are being filed for both a retirement benefit and a widow's benefit at the young age of, let's say, 62. And just the fact that somebody at Social Security checked a box on their behalf because they didn't write down in the remarks section they didn't want this to be done for them. Somebody checks a box on a form. Now they lose $200,000 or $300,000 because of that, because they could have taken their widow's benefit and let their retirement benefit grow through 70, or taken their retirement benefit first and let their widow's benefit grow and take that later. You don't want to be taking both at once. The software, if you follow the software's guidance, you won't be making these mistakes. You want to let them make these mistakes. So, yeah, getting a floor to your living standard is really important. And you're absolutely right that it starts with Social Security. It's, for most people, it's the most important or the second most important financial instrument. And we have a sense that it's whatever it is, you know, we don't have any decisions about it. Well, we do. We have a whole ton of decisions.
Yeah, there's a lot of choices.
Yeah.
The sad part, too, Larry, is that many, what we found in our, you know, we've been in business and practice 41 years, and we're retirement distribution planning specialists. So we help people when they're 5 years before retirement all the way to life end. But Social Security, there's so many people are leaving so much money on the table. They're hurting, but yet they have a benefit right there at their fingertips. And I tell you, I just popped up your website, MaximizeMySocialSecurity.com. What a great, easy tool for a listener out there to really maximize their own program. And by the way, one of the things we'll do for you, too, when you call in for your master plan review, is that we will maximize your Social Security in our elements of advice. And we will send you a copy of that as well. So number to call, of course, 252-249-0100 if you want your Social Security maximized. We'll have that set up on our website as well, Larry. It's a great new tool that you've come out with, and we thank you. And we use Maxify right now that you provided us with, and that's a great tool as well.
Gary, that tool, which does full financial planning, that's the basic plan is a tool costs $139 a year. It does the Social Security optimization as well, so you wouldn't need to buy both tools. But if you're using Maxify with your clients, that'll get the Social Security right. But what you're saying is so important that you need to think about not just Social Security, but retirement accounts. Should I be Roth converting? How does my taking Social Security early impact whether or not it makes any sense to Roth convert? Because when I do a Roth conversion, I'm going to kick up my taxes, and I might kick up my Social Security, the taxation of my Social Security benefits that would not otherwise be taxed.
One of the things we help our clients out with immensely is managing retirement withdrawals. And that's really the key you're hitting on. Which monies do you take first when you retire? Because many people automatically assume at 62, well, let's get that Social Security turned on. But if you have other money set aside, it might be more beneficial to use the other money and grow that Social Security a little bit greater than the basics. You indicated earlier, Larry, that there's a 76% difference of income between age 62 and 70 in their Social Security benefit adjusted for inflation. And that is a huge differential. 76%, folks, is almost double what you're going to get from 62 to 70. So it pays to wait. And if you wait till full retirement age, it increases at the rate of 6% a year. And then once you're full retirement age all the way to 70, the increase on your annual benefit projection is 8% a year. And I'll tell you can add that up pretty quickly and add a lot to your money. But it's important is to spend the right money first in the right order. Many people blow that day one and they end up blowing their retirement early.
Yeah, a lot of people are taking their Social Security first, as you're indicating, and taking their retirement account later. Sure, they're going to make a killing on the market. The market's a great casino. It's the best casino going because it's earning about 9% real adjusted for inflation. But there's a huge swing back and up and down. So you wouldn't want to depend on the stock market, whereas Social Security is sure income. So building a floor to your living standard by being patient and de-risking yourself by taking some of the money out of the market, out of your retirement account. But also you may be saving taxes by, everybody thinks that if you leave more money in your retirement accounts, you're saving taxes, but you can also be bunching up your withdrawals in your later life, later years, to the point where you're pushing yourself into a higher tax bracket. So that's where the Maxify Planner tool is really good at figuring out, how can I lower my lifetime taxes? The program actually automatically figures out when you should start withdrawals to lower your lifetime taxes. And generally, you wouldn't want to wait till 75. You can now wait till 75 before you're forced to take retirement account withdrawals from like a regular IRA.
The required minimum distributions for 2023 increases the beginning age to age 73. This year it was raised, or in 2022, it was raised to age 72. Now they have an increasing scale. It's in 23, it goes to 73, and 24, it goes to 74, levels off in 25 all the way up to age 75, and then it stops right there. What Larry's saying is by the time you're 75, your full retirement age on top of the required minimum distribution, that amount that is accruing is going to be a much greater number. And by the way, how we calculate the required minimum distribution is based on your age, the amount of money in your account on December 31st of the year that you're going to take the benefit, and then the tax table that the government uses in effect. And that rate at 75 is much higher than it is at 72. We're instructing people already to start taking your retirement money that's taxable early. Take it as early as possible. Get the tax out of the way or convert it to a Roth. I mean, there's a lot of different options you can use there as well.
Yeah, especially given the inflation. The inflation is making the effective tax rate, because the inflation component of our return on our investments is subject to taxation. So there's a bigger reason for converting to a Roth than there used to be, because we're in an inflationary environment. And then absolutely right, Gary, it might be best for people to start taking their retirement account money even at 59. They're not going to face a penalty. Yes, they're not going to gain from the deferral of the taxation on the interest that's earned, but they will be able to smooth their tax bracket over this period. So nobody can know for sure unless you run through our software, because the software is really geared towards, it's designed to answer these questions. But there's an article I wrote, a couple articles I want to tell people about. They're on my, if you go to larrykotlikoff.substack.com or just Google my name, Kotlikoff and Substack, you'll come up to this newsletter, which I have started about a half a year ago, putting out this newsletter, which also has podcasts, and I put up something called The Financial Riddler. Let me just tell you really quickly about two newsletters. One is about whether it pays to wait till 75 to take your retirement account distribution. So I just took a typical, well, not a typical, but a pretty high income retiree with a pretty high retirement account, large Social Security benefit, and should he take his Social Security benefit early in his retirement account later versus the other way? And should he wait till 75 because he wasn't going to become, he was going to be, he was young enough so that he was going to be able to start his minimum distribution withdrawals at 75. Well, it turned out that he should start his retirement withdrawals in his early 60s, not at 75. even a very high income person, it didn't behoove him to wait, as would be suggested by Wall Street. Wall Street wants you to leave your money with them and wait till 75 to start any withdrawals. And the other paper that's worth looking at, which is either their Substack or Kotlikoff.net, it's about a study that I did with the Federal Reserve Bank of Atlanta on how much money people are leaving on the table from not optimizing their Social Security. The typical amount that was being left is about $82K. We should have about 90% of our people taking their retirement benefit at 70. Only 10% are. That's what the study shows. So there's enormous mistake being made systematically. And you got some people at the extreme. We had a couple in this data set that we're running, which is the Federal Reserve Survey of Consumer Finances. It surveys about 6,000 American households around the country, representative sample. One couple was giving up roughly almost a million bucks by screwing up the Social Security decision. So the typical loss is 82,000, but some people can be losing in the hundreds of thousands, and that doesn't have to happen. We don't need to make that mistake.
We're talking to Dr. Larry Kotlikoff, PhD from Harvard. The doctor is a economist. He lectures and teaches over at Boston University, and also the author of many books, including Money Magic and Get What's Yours. First 10 callers today, folks, we're giving away a copy of the Money Magic book to the first 10 callers at 252-249-0100. And we'll also do a complimentary financial review for you, including we will maximize your Social Security using Dr. Larry's new software program. You know what's cool, though, what I tell people on the radio, which is really nice, using your software as an economist, using our software as a financial advisor, they formulate things a little bit differently, but they meet at the right spot, at the maximization spot of where you need to be to have the most fullest and happiest retirement along the way, because you got taxes, you got economic eyes looking at it, and you got not just a normal set of economic eyes, you got a PhD from Harvard looking at it. And I always kid with Jeffrey, Larry, about when we bring you up on our radio show, I always kid around saying, you know, Jeffrey, I sent a copy of an application to Harvard to get in when I was in college days, and never heard back from them. So I'm assuming they didn't want anything to do with me. But Dr. Larry has got a PhD here from Harvard, so congratulations on that as well.
Just to say to people that didn't get into Harvard, I got in by luck. And, you know, you could be wearing your Harvard sweatshirt for the rest of your life, and 30 years later, won't matter a hell beans for how much you're earning. And economists have actually studied this, that how hard you work, you know, your ability to be creative, these are things that you can't learn anywhere. Your parents teach you, or it's just innate. If you work hard, if you're dedicated, if you find your niche, if you're creative, if you find things that where you are creative, that's where you're going to find your sweet spot. But Harvard's not going to do it for you. And nobody's going to give a damn or ask you when you're 50 where you went to school, or if you say you went to Harvard, you know, it'll probably count against you. you went to Harvard and you're not a billionaire? Come on. So I think nobody knows who smart is. My next book I was thinking about writing, I've written 20. The next one may be called Nobody Knows What Smart Is.
Well, Dr. Larry Kotlikoff, we thank you so much, sir, for joining us on the Mastering Your Money program. And if you have a question or you need more information on Larry or one of his books, give us a call right here as well, 252-249-0100. Complimentary book of Money Magic to the first 10 callers today at 252-249-0100. And Larry, again, thank you so much for joining us live on the Mastering Your Money program. And we will talk to you again very soon, sir.
Great. Great pleasure, Gary. You take care.
Always a pleasure. Dr. Larry Kotlikoff. I'm Gary Mastrodonato. It's been a pleasure being with you today on the Mastering Your Money program. Hard to believe we're out of time already, but the time flies when you're having a lot of great information. And we thank Dr. Larry Kotlikoff again for a great interview. Thank you, Dr. K. We thank Jeff Shade in the other room for helping us out as well. Thank you, Jeffrey.
You are welcome. Always a pleasure, Gary.
And we thank all of our coaches, and we thank our staff, both locally here in Oriental and, of course, in Kansas City, Atlanta, and Omaha, Nebraska. Thank you so much for what you do for the Mastering Your Money program, and we thank you over in Port St. Lucie. Let's end with a prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day, and we thank you to keep us all safe. Please keep families in mind, especially for those that are gravely ill, including my sister-in-law right now, that we are praying for on a daily basis. My brother's wife, help us to help heal her to get better. In Jesus' name we pray, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Amen. Thank you, Jeffrey, and thank you, everybody. The Mastering Your Money Show continues next week. See you all again soon, and stay safe on the Mastering Your Money program.
No statements made during the Mastering Your Money show shall constitute tax, legal, or accounting advice. You should consult your own legal or tax professional on your individual information. Past performance is not a guarantee of future results. No investment strategy, including asset allocation or diversification, guarantees a profit or the avoidance of loss.